Hey there, guys. Welcome to Anthony Reviews. We're Anthony Reviews. And today we are looking at another McFarlane DC Multiverse figure. Last review I think I did was on The Flash, Barry Allen The Flash. And today we're going to be looking at the John Stewart Green Lantern figure. So I'm sure there are plenty of other reviews on the internet, but I got this figure. As you probably all know, I'm a Green Lantern fan. You know, Hal Jordan's my main guy, but I do have a lot of love for all the other Lanterns like John and Kyle and so on and so forth. So I got this figure, felt like I had something to say about it. So without further ado, let's get into the review on the John Stewart Green Lantern figure from McFarlane Toys. Choosing a Green Lantern can be tough. Whether it's for a movie, comic book, or like here an action figure line, you have an embarrassment of riches. Personally, I don't think there's a bad choice to make. So when McFarlane Toys announced they would be making John Stewart to go along with their other DC Multiverse figures, it made perfect sense to me. At the time this figure was put into production, John Stewart was the main Green Lantern on the Justice League in the comics, and of course Stewart has always had the insane popularity from being in the Justice League cartoons back in the early 2000s. Will this figure satisfy those fans? Let's find out. The figure here is definitely the most unique to come from the multiverse line from McFarlane thus far, in my opinion. While some liberties have been taken with characters before, this time Todd and his team have gone all out with putting their own stamp on this figure. The entire suit is covered with sculpted detail, which at first can be detracting for some. But luckily, this toy keeps the overall design of John Stewart intact. With a character that is meant to be patrolling space, I guess you can get away with adding a bit of lines here and some ridges there. You get the idea. The face sculpt really stands out to me. Unlike the rest of the body, the head is somewhat subdued in its presentation. Rather than going for a somewhat animated expression, Stewart is more stoic, which I do believe fits the character. The green chosen for the suit is also perfect for this figure. I know the green for Green Lantern can vary here to there, but here, I think they got it right. I'd also say if you were to put him next to any movie or video game versions of DC characters, he'd fit in just fine. I actually don't have any figures from McFarlane that are from anything live action, so just imagine that, I guess. Let's move on to the articulation. Articulation has been an interesting talking point when it comes to these figures. While some fans absolutely adore the range of posability, others have often questioned the decisions made, such as why do the wrists and ankles have to look so awkward with the ball and pin joints? And why isn't there a proper thigh swivel, or even a calf swivel? It's 2021, Todd! I need them legs to swivel! And so on. While I do understand some of these complaints to a point, they have yet to affect me enough to that I find them annoying. This line has been going on for over a year now, and we've gotten dozens of figures. At least for the time being, I think fans will have to accept that this just is the way the line is going to be done. Now let's get on to the accessories. One of the first things you'll notice when buying this figure is the green construct overlay that he has on his chest and shoulders. Along with a massive gun and backpack, these really help the figure stand out amongst other GLs. Green Lantern constructs are nothing new for Green Lantern toys, but the color of these and the general design are so good I think fans will think these are some of the best ones yet. With that being said though, we are missing one crucial piece. This figure comes with no alternate hands. Which at first isn't too shocking, not every figure has to come with alternate hands at this point, but this is where one alternate hand would be absolutely needed. You see, the gun John has needs two hands to grip it, which means this gripping hand is the only ring hand you'll get. And that means he has no fist with the ring on it. Nearly every Green Lantern figure before him features a fist with the ring on it, and for good reason. When you picture Hal or John or whoever ring-slinging through space, you imagine them with their fist held strong as they blast, build, or whatever. Without that piece, you can't even have him do the oath correctly. Not that he comes with a lantern either. You probably thought I was going to say he was missing a lantern, but no, it's the fist that's more important here. While the rest of the figure is downright spectacular in my eyes, I do feel like the lack of fist keeps it from being an all-time favorite of mine. Despite the lack of a fist though, this figure is still one of the coolest additions to anyone's Green Lantern or Justice League collections. This John manages to capture all the heroism and strength that is associated with the character. I said at the beginning of the review that you can't really go wrong with any Green Lantern, and I stand by that. Now with John here though, we have the opposite problem. Now, we need all the Lanterns to join him. So there you guys go. Those were my thoughts on the DC Multiverse McFarlane Toys John Stewart Green Lantern figure. Like I said, there's some things that I love about it, and there's one particular thing that keeps it from being at the top for me. So it's still a fantastic figure. I highly, highly recommend that you pick it up if you're a fan of Green Lantern or Justice League or whatever. It's showing that you can try different things with this brand while still staying in the lines, kind of. I don't know. It's a cool figure. But thank you guys so much for watching. Feel free to check out some of my other content. I've got other reviews. I've got collection videos, comparisons, all sorts of cool stuff. I'm at Anthony Lantern on Instagram and Twitter. If you'd like to check out my thoughts there, subscribe if you like, ring a bell. I hear it does a thing. But that's pretty much it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you're all vaccinated, and take care.